He has gutted the environmental assessment rules, turning over regulatory oversight to the mining, oil and gas, and pulp and paper industries, and has allowed an amendment to the Fisheries Act that allows mining companies to actually have healthy lakes, fish buried lakes, renamed tailing impoundment areas so that they can be poisoned. Canada is the only country in the world that ratified the Kyoto Protocol and then officially abandoned it. Stephen Harper went to Copenhagen expressly warning of its failure in advance. Recently, Canada sought to block a moratorium on geoengineering at the Convention on Biological Diversity, led by the wonderful ETC group. Geoengineering is the latest fad of those with too much money and not enough brains to deal with climate change by large-scale interventions to adjust planetary systems such as pumping and sequestering greenhouse gases in the ocean. Bill Gates is into this big time. Under this government, Canada has also retreated from its former stellar international stand on human rights. As you know, we've heard tonight, Canada voted against the UN Declaration on the Rights of Indigenous Peoples. And has been the most vocal opponent of the right to water at the United Nations of any country in the world. Let us face it, Canada under the Harper government is increasingly seen as a human rights denying echo outlaw. I love my country, and I cannot believe I would ever have to say such a thing. But it is based on the Harper government's record, the United Nations should deny Canada the seat at the Security Council. Stephen Harper will use this summit to promote the growth in the tar sands, Canada's Mordor, and the real reason he took us out of Kyoto. He will welcome the global mining, oil and gas industries into a free-for-all for our North, and he's also promised to deregulate the North to make this happen. And he will promote the Canada-European Union Comprehensive Economic and Trade Agreement, the biggest trade deal ever negotiated here, and one that will expose every school, every hospital, daycare, water service, green energy project, public works, and anything else you name, and any value that we translate into local fair trade rules or rules around green energy and so on, anything like that will be considered a barrier to trade and open for challenge under this trade agreement. And they get to go after the subnational contracts and subnational spending that has eluded them till now. This is a terribly dangerous agreement, and I was so thrilled to hear John Hilary speaking about the willingness to work across the ocean against this. No wonder Jonas Gahr Støre, who's the Foreign Ministry of Norway, says the G20 lacks legitimacy and is the biggest step back. He and many of us joined with millions of voices around the world tonight to say, scrap this damn summit. No more!